I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Winter Haven. I'm Haley, and you're watching BDTV for Friday, January 15th, 2021. Coming up on today's show, second semester information and how to stay focused. At home, 'cause I was doing better alone, but when you said hello, I knew there was the end of it all. I should have stayed.
I'm Tyler.
And I'm Kylie. Let's get into the announcements.
Kylie, aren't you glad that we're able to anchor with each other again?
Yes, of course. Thanks to this plexiglass, we can now interact in a safe way.
Students, please be sure to check your emails daily and for testing information from your teachers.
Don't forget, you must wear your mask and cover your nose while on campus for your safety and others. Also, gaiters will still be allowed on campus, but if they are made with one layer of material, the gaiter must be folded over to create two layers, covering your nose and mouth. Additionally, students and staff cannot wear masks with ports per CDC guidelines.
The new scholarship bulletin for January 2021 is out now. These scholarships are for seniors unless said otherwise.
Have you pre-ordered your yearbook yet? Save up to $5 and order before January 31st, before it goes up to $75. Hurry if you'd like to have your name engraved in the yearbook. Deadline for orders is February 14th. See Ms. Jaime in order form or go to www.johnsons.com.
Attention seniors, cap and gown photos will be taken on January 26th in the Media Center. You will need have an appointment to be photographed. The appointment signups is located on Winter Haven High School Class of 2021 Schoology group page.
The senior panoramic photo has been rescheduled to January 20th during the beginning of fourth period in the gym. This will also be an early dismissal day. Don't forget to mark your calendars.
Attention to all e-learners that are coming back to school on Tuesday for the second semester. Report to the media center above the office when you get to school on Tuesday. Everyone else report to first period.
Let's go to Kara for some more information.
As we all know, the new semester is starting next week. I'm Kara with BDTV, here to help you start the new semester off right. Attention all e-learners returning to campus. Once you come to school, go to the media center above the main office and check in, which there you will have four steps you need to follow. Step one, once you enter the media center, you will see tables set up to where you can return all your laptops. Step two, then you'll have to go and get your paper copy of your schedule. There will be counselors handing them out by last names. Step three, if needed, there will be plenty of bus schedules being handed out. And last but not least, step four, after you finish those past three steps, you will then report to class. And if you need help, there will be some ROTC members to help you around campus. And attention all returning on-campus students. Once you come to school, report to your first period class. There, you'll be given your new schedule. Once you have your schedule, there will then be an announcement telling you to report to your new classes. And make sure you do not get rid of that paper schedule because you have to show your teachers in order to enter the classroom. And students, remember, grades start over due to the new semester, so make sure you keep up with your work and finish out the school year strong. I'm Kara with BDTV. See you around campus.
You know, Kylie, it's crazy that it's almost second semester of our senior year.
I know. Speaking of senior year, the deadline to purchase a senior recognition ad in the yearbook is February 1st. All orders must be placed online at www.johnstonsadservice.com. See Ms. Jaime for more information.
You can find your student obligations on Student Portal. If you have any overdue library books, those will be under the Library tab. Contact Ms. Sia, our Finance and Athletic Secretary, for any questions or to make payments.
Softball tryouts have already started. Make sure you have your paperwork prior to showing up to these tryouts.
Congratulations to our varsity soccer team for their win against Lakeland.
Another congratulations to our junior varsity girls soccer team for their own win against Lakeland.
Fellowship of Christian Athletes will not be meeting for the next 2 weeks, but will resume the week of January 25th. Stay tuned for new meeting days and times.
FTL Fill in the Lane basketball tryouts will be held January 26th and 27th at 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. All Winter Haven Fieldhouse. This opportunity is for 9th through 11th grade boys. Scholarships will be offered only at this run, and any player seeking a scholarship must attend both tryouts. Good luck and have fun.
National Honor Society will begin evaluating 11th and 12th grade students for membership soon. To qualify, you must have a minimum of 3.5 weighted GPA and have a minimum of 45 hours of community service hours posted. The deadline to have 45 service hours is January 22nd. And you know, to be an NHS, you have to stay really focused. And here's some tips.
Starting a new year means there's a new semester to tackle. Tackling a new semester can be difficult with all the new work and new challenges coming your way. I'm Skylar with BDTV, here to show you three ways to tackle the new semester. First way to tackle a new semester is by staying focused. There are many ways to stay focused into the new year. A really good way to stay focused is by writing in a planner or taking notes for what you'll need for the new semester. The second way to tackle a new semester is by setting a goal. The goal that you set must be attainable, and the most important part of setting a goal is actually doing it. The third way to tackle a new semester is by studying. But studying all hours of the night the night before a test is not going to help because you're not retaining information. When you're studying, try not to rush through it and spread it out. When you're studying for a big test, don't try and study the night before. That is way too much information to try and cram into your head. Instead, try studying over a longer period of time. That way you have plenty of time to get all the information. Now you guys have three ways to tackle the new semester. I'm Skylar with BDTV. Have fun tackling the new year and new semester.
I wonder if the girls' basketball team stays focused. Congratulations to our girls' basketball members, Trinity Hardy, Samari Phillips, Jasmine Peaks, and Jasmine Spencer, for all receiving the McDonald's All-American nominees. Seniors, Herf Jones will be taking cap and gown orders in the cafeteria during all lunches on Tuesday, January 26th. Do not miss this opportunity. Winter Haven Basketball is selling fan shirts for 2021 season. Each design is long sleeve and dry fit. $15 per shirt and $20 for 2X sizes. Exact change only for checks made out to Winter Haven High School. See either Miss Jordan or Miss Phillips to support. Congratulations to our boys junior varsity basketball team for their win against Edgewater. Introducing the inaugural Midwinter Classic 5K benefiting the Lady Blue Devils cross country and track and field teams. This event is a family-friendly event at Simmers Young, 9 a.m. on Saturday, February 13th. There will also be a virtual option for those who want to stay at home. Register at the link below. The sophomore class has extended their fundraiser through January 29th. There will be jars in the cafeteria labeled with teacher and administration names. The jar with the most money will get the pie in the face, and the second place winner will be Silly String. Please be sure to check it out. And that's all for today, Winter Haven. I'm Haley at BDTV. Have a great day.
I be on my suit and tie. I be on. my suit and tie.